Well, there is now a new little and large duo. This one here on the left is the heaviest clock I've ever owned. Apart from that long case clock, possibly. It is made from solid stone. Slate, in fact. Both these clocks are made from slate. This one isn't quite so big. It's actually one of the smallest black slate clocks I've ever seen, in fact. This, on the other hand, is so heavy, it generates its own gravity. I carried both clocks home. It was only a couple of hundred yards, but that was an arm-stretching experience, I can tell you. Okay, let's hear this one. It sounds a bit like a Smith's Enfield, I reckon. I like the finish on the black slate. It's a nice, smooth finish, and it's in very, very good condition. And I like those metal pillars. And the stamped out decoration above the dial. It really is a very decorative clock, but it needs a strong surface to stand on. This one isn't quite so big. It's actually a really small clock for a slate clock. I'll let you hear it striking. The back of the clock has a glass panel. It is a very ordinary French movement that has that dreaded French rack striking. And this is inside the big clock. Also that dreaded French rack striking. I say dreaded rack striking because the snail is solid rather than stepped. So if you trigger the striking at any time other than the hour, there is a risk of the gathering pallet hitting the end of the rack teeth and jamming the striking. Also, if the striking fails for any reason, because the end of the rack tail is solid, it will hit the end of the snail and jam the clock. So if the striking fails, the clock will stop just after 12 or coming to 1 o'clock. And if you try and push the hands, because the hands are very delicate, you'll snap the minute hand off. So French rack striking is not just the best thing. The count wheel striking is actually safer. Which, surprisingly enough, is what that clock has. But I'm fairly sure that that will not happen. I won't let it happen. Well, that is my Smith electric clock you're hearing now. And the uninspiring sound of my Horlicks French wall clock. So I now have four clocks in my collection with the round style French movement. These two, that one, and this one, which I call the corned beef clock. Oh, and a word of advice to anyone who has one of these clocks and doesn't have a key for it. I bought this key from a supplier on eBay. It's a 4mm key with a 1.75mm end for the regulating square. And it doesn't fit. And I can't get one smaller than that. I can't get one with a smaller, small end, I should say. And it doesn't fit the regulating square on either of these clocks, or that red one that I call the corned beef clock. It doesn't fit that either. They are undeniably a very impressive pair. Okay, if you like this video, please click like and subscribe. My Facebook link is down below, and I'll see you in the next video.